Good morning. Today our subject is goods and service tax. So we'll start with the introduction. The objectives of goods and service tax. After going through this unit, you should be able to understand the goods and service tax concept, define the terms of taxes, you know the tax structure, understand the basics of GST, and explain the features of indirect taxes in this PPT. So we start with the meaning of goods and service tax. This is the GST, and this came into effect from July 1st, 2017. Goods and service tax is the single best tax reform undertaken since independence to ease compliance. This is a one nation, one tax to the one market, and one tax for the manufacturing, trading, and services. GST is a destination-based tax, that is a tax on goods and services, which will be paid at the point of the receiving of the goods and services. The GST levied will be levied on all the transactions such as sale, transfer, purchase, barter, lease or import of goods and services. So this is the tax which is known as the goods and service tax, the GST, and it came into effect from the 1st July 2017. The GST is the single best tax to reform other the taxes. This is the one nation, one tax to the one market, and it reduces the tax burden of the taxpayer with the one tax for the manufacturing, trading, and GST. It is just a destination-based tax, that a tax on goods and services you will have to pay after the point of receiving the goods and services. GST will be levied on all the transactions such as sale, transfer, purchase, and barter, lease, and import of the goods and services. Goods and service tax, the GST, is levied on supply of goods and services or both at each stage of supply chain, starting from manufacture or import till the last retail level. So this is a supply chain, and this tax will be starting from the manufacture or import till the last retail level, and we have to pay the tax after the receiving of the goods and services. The GST will be administered together by the state and the center, involving both the central and the state levels. Tax society and the country. Civilized society pays tax. Honest taxpayers are asset of nation, payment of tax, gratefulness towards society, soldiers, farmers, country, etc. The payment of taxes mean wealth from haves and have-nots. Now we are going to read the subsumming of existing taxes. In CGST, the central goods and service tax, the subsumming of that existing taxes, the first one is central excise, additional duties on customs, CVD, the service tax, and the surcharge, and all the taxes are subsuming in the one tax, that is the CGST. Now come to the second, the SGST, state goods and service tax. In this tax, the subsuming of these existing taxes, the first of all is VAT and the sales tax, entertainment tax, luxury tax, lottery tax, and the entry tax, purchase tax. These all the taxes are subsuming in the CGST. Now come to the IGST, and this is subsuming is the CST, the central and the state tax. Now come to the tax structure in India. Tax system in India traces its origin to the prehistoric taxes. The Arthashastra and the Manu Samriti, taxes were paid by the farmers and artisans in the form of agricultural produce, silver, and the gold. Modern tax system in India was introduced by the Sir James William Wilson during the British rule in India in 1860. So according to modern tax system in India, this taxes was introduced by the Sir James Wilson during British rule in India in 1860. The taxes were paid by the farmers and artisans in the form of agricultural produce, the silver and gold. Tax structure in India is a three-tier federation structure, the central, the state, and the local municipal bodies. Power to levy and collect taxes emerges from the Constitution of India. The Article 265, no tax shall be levied on levied or collected except by the authority of law. According to Article 265, no tax shall be levied or collected except by the authority of the law, prohibits arbitrary collection of taxes. In Article 246, the authority to enact law and levy taxes and duties is given by the Article 246. Authority to enact the law and to levy the taxes and all the duties is given in Article 246. The Parliament may make laws for the whole of India or any part of the territory of the India. The state legislature may make laws for whole or the part of the state. Now come to the constitutional framework of the state taxes before GST. In administrative terms, in India is a federation of many states and union territories strengthened by the central and the axis. In the seventh schedule of the constitution list the taxes power of union and states. List one of seventh schedule listed by the taxation power of the central government via entries 82 to entries 92 and the entry 97. All the taxes were scheduled in the sections 7th schedule in the list 1 is recorded into the entries 82 to entries 92. And list 2 of 7th schedule listed of the taxation power of the state government and the entries recorded in the section 46 to 63. The list 3 does not contain any entry means union and state had no concurrent power of taxation. So residual powers of taxation belonged to union wide entry 97 of list 1. Using such power, union government imposed service tax and the constitution does not provide any taxation powers to local government. In the list 1, the taxation power of the central government and the list 2 of the 7th schedule mentioned in the Texas taxation power of the state government and entries is the 45 to 63. So now come to the taxes in list 1 of the 7th schedule. Taxation power of the central government. Entry 82, taxes on income other than agricultural income. So in the entry 82, levy of taxes on all types of all kinds of income other than agricultural income. In entry 83, duties of custom including export duty. In these custom duties, it is including the export duty also in entry 83. Entry 84, duties of excise except on alcoholic liquor, narcotics, but including medicinal and preparation containing alcohol. Excise duty is levied in entry 84 products except on alcoholic liquor and narcotics but including the medicinal and preparation containing the alcohol. Excise duty is levied on the containing of alcohol and preparation of the medicinal products. Entry 85 corporation tax. Entry 86 taxes on capital value of assets exclusive of agricultural land of individual and companies. So entry 87, estate duty is respect of property other than agricultural income. According to entry 87, the estate duty taxes is levied in respect of property but other than agricultural land. Entry 88, duties in respect of succession of property other than agricultural land. And entry 89, terminal taxes on goods and passenger carried by railway, sea or air. Taxes on rail fares and freight. So list in taxes in list 1, entry 90, taxes on transaction in stock exchange and future markets other than stamp duty. A person will liable to pay tax on the transaction in stock exchange and future markets but other than the stamp duty. According to entry 91, rate of stamp duty on bills of exchange, check, promissory notes, bill of lading, letter of credit, and policies of insurance, transfer of shares and debentures are levied according to entry 91. In entry 92, taxes on sale or purchase of newspaper and on advertisement published therein. So when we publish some advertisement in newspaper or when we sale or purchase of newspaper, the tax levied on some rate of taxes on levied on such types of and advertisement according to entry 92. Entry 92C, the taxes on services. Entry 97, any other matter not included in list 2, that is the residual powers. Now come to the list 2, according to the 7th schedule, taxation power of state government. So we start with entry 45, the land revenues. When we sale or purchase of the land and when we gain income from that particular land, so we have to pay the taxes according to entry 45. Entry 46, the taxes on agricultural income is levied. Entry 47, duties in respect of succession to agricultural land. Entry 48, estate duty in respect of agricultural land is levied. Entry 49, taxes on lands and building will be collected and paid by the consumers. Entry 50, taxes on mineral rights. Entry 51, duties of excise on alcoholic liquor and narcotics at the time of manufacture and produce within the state. So come to the entry 52, taxes on entry of goods into a local area for consumption, use and sale. Entry 53, taxes on the consumption of sale of electricity. When we consume or sale of electricity, the rate of tax will be applied according to entry 53. Entry 54, the taxes on sale and purchase of goods other than newspaper will be levied, rate of taxes will be levied according to entry 54. And entry 55, taxes on advertisement other than advertisement published in newspaper and advertisement broadcast by the radio and TV, the rate of taxes will be applicable on the basis of entry 55. Entry 56, taxes on goods and passenger carried by road and inland water. Entry 57, taxes on vehicle. When we sale or purchase of any kind of vehicle, we shall be levied to pay tax. And entry 58, taxes on animals and boats. Entry 59, the taxes we have to pay tax according to entry 59 on tolls. Entry 60, taxes on professions, trade, callings and employment. When we do any profession, do any trade and employment, so we have to pay taxes according to entry 60. Entry 61, capitalization taxes. Entry 62, taxes on luxuries including taxes on entertainment, amusement, betting and gambling. So all kind of these taxes we have to pay under the entry 62. Entry 63, rate of stamp duty in respect of documents other than specified in the provision of listed one with regard to state rate of stamp duty according to entry 63. So this is all about the central and the state tax taxes in the list 1 and 2. So we start with the pre-GST tax structure in India. When GST was not introduced and not levied in India, the structure, the tax structure was like, tax structure in, there are two types of taxes, the direct tax and the indirect taxes. In direct taxes, the income tax, the wealth tax, and the indirect taxes, it is further divided into two subparts, the central taxes and the state taxes. Under the central taxes, the excise duty, the custom duty, and the service tax will be levied. And under the state tax, the VAT and the entry tax, the luxury tax, the lottery tax, etc. These all the taxes are levied or paid by the consumer. So with the GST, we reduce the tax burden with all of the taxes, the income tax, the wealth tax, the central and the state, excise, service, custom, VAT. These all these taxes are subsuming in the one tax, the CGST, SGST, or the IGST. These are all the parts of the GST. Indirect taxes is collected by the intermediary. burden is not transferred in form of taxes, but as a part of the prices of goods and services. VAT is a multi-stage tax levied at each stage of the value addition chain, with a provision to allow input tax credit, the ITC, on tax paid at the earlier stage, that which can be apportioned against the VAT liability on the subsequent sale. So this is the tax structure, pre-GST tax structure in India. So now come to the main features of the indirect taxes. First one is the taxable event. Taxes are levied on sale, purchase, manufacture of goods and provision of the services. When we sell, when we purchase or manufacture of goods and services, at every step we have to pay the tax. So this is known as a taxable event. Incidence and impact falls on two different persons. The tax burden is shifted by the supplier to the buyer. And regressive taxation, it does not depend on paying capacity. Impact of indirect taxes on goods and services. The increase in prices hence leads to inflation. Promotes welfare. It also promotes the welfare. Harmful, sinful products like alcohol, tobacco, etc. may be taxed at the higher rate. And the major source of the revenue, more than 50% total tax revenue, it is the major source of the government of the revenue. Now come to the defects in the tax structure in indirect taxes before the GST. The cascading effect. Cascading effect is what? The tax on tax. VAT was also payable on excise duty, the component of the price, resulting in cascading effect. No credit of services tax paid on input services and used in selling of goods and provided by the state government. So which tax was levied on the tax boosted inflation? VAT is also payable on excise duty. And this is known as the cascading effect, when we have to pay tax on tax, when the supplier, when a manufacturer buys the goods or buys the raw materials, he has to pay the tax. After that, he makes some goods in the semi raw material, and after that, after making the semi finished goods, he sell the goods to the another person. He also has to pay some kind of taxes, and the buyer also pay has to some kind of taxes. So this is the cascading effect when we have to pay tax on taxes. So after the GST, we reduces that tax burden, cascading effect after introducing the GST. Multiplicity of taxes and the cells. Tax structure cumbersome as number of taxes were levied in the pre-GST regime. Excise duty, the VAT, the entry tax, the luxury tax, the entertainment tax, the service tax, and the off-try duty, etc. So these are the multiplicity of the taxes. Overlapping of jurisdiction. Distinction between goods and services was difficult. Hence, overlapping of the state VAT and the central services tax. Works contract, food related services in restaurant, caterers, computer softwares, SIM cards, renting of movable properties, etc. These are all the overlapping of the jurisdiction. Rivalry among states. Pre-GST tax regime was origin based tax. Taxes were collected and utilized by the state administration, where goods and services were transacted and manufactured on supply. So this encouraged the state to provide the sales tax and the VAT relief on the goods and services. It is discouraged the supply of goods from other state by imposing entry tax, off-try, and the luxury tax. Now come to the point fifth. Hindrance to integrated market system. Due to invisible barriers of CST, the VAT, and the entry tax, check post of the boundaries of the state. So these are all the hindrances integrated in market system. Due to invisible barriers of the CST, the VAT, and the entry tax, and the entertainment tax, the off-try taxes. So these are all the boundaries of the states. Loss of man and trucks are due to check posts mounted by the state on entry points plus huge corruption, difficulty in compliance of taxpayers, multiplicity of taxes, the tax laws, multiple tax authorities, the different taxable events like manufacture, foreign excise duty, import and export for goods and custom duty, rendering of services for service tax, transfer of ownership for sales tax and VAT, and it also compliance required voluminous effort on the part of the taxpayer. So this is the difficulty in compliance of taxpayer, and it reduces by the introducing the GST. Difficulty in cross verification of credit availed by the assessee, because there are lots of taxes paid by the manufacturers, suppliers, and then consumers. So we have to difficulty in cross verification of all these taxes. But now, with the introduction of the GST, the cross verification is also easier due to lack of the online data, and the verification was done offline. Difficult of tax department to get verification report from suppliers and the fraudulent creditors. Tax evasion. With the lots of burden of the taxpayer, taxes, the taxpayer are sometimes to reduce, to evade the tax with the burden of the taxes, to burden of compliance, multiplicity of tax laws, fudging of records, concealment of transactions, bribing of taxes, official increase this propensity of the evade of taxes. Huge amount of litigation, lots of disputes regarding availment of credit, determining of manufacturer of goods, values of goods, classification of goods, resulted in the pendency of the tax demands. So these are all the defects in the tax structure of indirect taxes before the GST. Now come to the 11th point, different points of taxation, lack of uniformity, multiplicity and repetitive compliance. So this is all about the introduction of the GST. So today we cover the introduction, meaning and the tax structure, the pre-GST tax structure and the defects in the structure of indirect taxes and the features of the indirect taxes. So this is all about for today. Thank you.